الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وسلم تسليما كثيرا ما بعد. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala abundantly the way He deserves to be praised, and we ask Allah to exalt the mention and grant peace and send His blessings and salutations upon the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My fellow Muslims, my beloved brothers and sisters, and my people of all races and types and colors, I'm happy to be with you here as we delve into session 7 or class 7 of the famous, valuable, beneficial book Al-Aqeedatul-Waasitiyyah with the sharh of Shaykh Ibn Uthaymeen rahmatullahi alayhi wa ala Shaykh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah wa jami'u ulama' al-Muslimin wa hafidhallahu man kana minhum ala qaydi al-hayat. In our last session, we were discussing and we were beginning to discuss the important topic of describing Allah Azza wa Jal. How do we describe Allah? We describe Allah with what Allah described Himself within the Quran, with what the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam described Allah with in his sunnah, and that we never transgress, we never go beyond the Quran and the sunnah. Now the Shaykh, hafidhahu rahimahullah, will highlight and explain by saying, وَيَدُلُّ لِذَلِكَ الْقُرْآنُ وَالْعَقْلِ. Now what indicates that are two things, the Qur'an and the intellect. فَفِي الْقُرْآنِ يَقُولُ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلُّ. In the Qur'an Allah says, قُلْ إِنَّمَا حَرَّمَ رَبِّيَ الْفَوَاحِشَ مَا ظَهَرَ مِنْهَا وَمَا بَطَنَ وَالْإِثْمَ وَالْبَغْيَ بِغَيْرِ الْحَقِّ وَأَنْ تُشْرِكُوا بِاللَّهِ مَا لَمْ يُنَزِّلْ بِهِ سُلْطَانًا وَأَنْ تَقُولُوا عَلَى اللَّهِ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Say, but the things that my Lord has indeed forbidden are fawahish. Fawahish are all types of sins, and usually specifically unlawful sexual intercourse, whether committed openly or secretly, sins of all kinds, unrighteous oppression, joining partners with Allah for which He has given you no authority, and lastly, and saying things about Allah of which you have no knowledge. And this is in Surah Al-A'raf, Ayah 33. One of the most dangerous things, ya brothers and sisters in faith, is to speak about Allah without knowledge. So we have to be very careful what to affirm to Allah and what to deny regarding Allah. What attribute we affirm that we have evidence for, what attribute we deny, meaning Allah does not have that attribute, such as Allah is not overtaken with slumber or sleep. لَا تَخُدُهُ سِنَةٌ وَلَا نَوْمٌ لَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٌ. There's nothing unlike unto Him. Anything which Allah Azza wa Jal negated, let me say, they use the term negated, is more particular, more accurate than deny. Anything which Allah negated, then we negate. We negate, we affirm as per the evidence. Our intellect has to be set aside. We will see why. فَإِذَا وَصَفْتَ اللَّهَ بِصِفَةٍ لَمْ يَصِفِ اللَّهُ بِهَا نَفْسَهُ فَقَدْ قُلْتَ عَلَيْهِ مَا لَمْ تَعْلَمْ وَهَذَا مُحَرَّمٌ بِنَصِّ الْقُرْآنِ. So if you were to describe Allah with a quality which Allah Azza wa Jal did not describe Himself with, then you have said and you have spoken about Allah without knowledge, and that is forbidden according to the specific and explicit textual evidence from the Quran. According to the Quran, it's haram. Why? وَأَنْ تَقُولُوا عَلَى اللَّهِ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. You should never speak about Allah without knowledge. Therefore, you can never describe Allah Azza wa Jal with an attribute or a quality that He did not describe Himself with. وَيَقُولُ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلُ وَلَا تَقْفُ مَا لَيْسَ لَكَ بِهِ عِلْمٌ إِنَّ السَّمْعَ وَالْبَصَرَ وَالْفُؤَادَ كُلُّ أُولَٰئِكَ كَانَ عَنْهُ مَسْؤُولًا. Allah further says, and follow not that of which you have no knowledge. Verily the hearing and the sight and the heart of each of those you will be questioned by Allah. فَإِذَا نعم وَلَوْ وَصَفْنَا اللَّهَ بِمَا لَمْ يَصِفْ بِهِ نَفْسَهُ لَكُنَّا قَفَوْنَا مَا لَيْسَ لَنَا بِهِ عِلْمٌ فَوَقَعْنَا فِي مَا نَهَى اللَّهُ عَنْهُ. And if we were then to describe Allah with something that He did not describe Himself with, we would be among those who are following that which we have no knowledge of. And then we would have fallen into that which Allah Azza wa Jal has prohibited. وَأَمَّا الدَّلِيلُ الْعَقْلِ. So that was from the Quran. What about intellectually? وَأَمَّا الدَّلِيلُ الْعَقْلِ فَلِأَنَّ صِفَاتِ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ مِنَ الْأُمُورِ الْغَيْبِيَّةِ ولا يمكن في الأمور في الأمور الغيبية أن يدركها العقل. As for the intellectual aspect, the attributes of Allah are from the matters of the unseen, and it is impossible for the intellect to grasp the matters of the unseen. The matters of the unseen, the human intellect cannot truly perceive them. وحينئذ لا نصف الله بما لم يصف به نفسه وَلَا نُكَيِّفْ صِفَاتَهْ لِأَنَّ ذَلِكَ غَيْرُ مُمْكِنْ. Therefore, we don't ever describe Allah Azza wa Jal with that which He did not describe Himself with, nor do we mention the how-ness, which is the term I've coined back in the day, nor do we describe the how-ness, because that is impossible. نَحْنُ الْآنْ لَا نُدْرِكْ مَا وَصَفَ اللَّهُ بِهِ نَعِيمَ الْجَنَّةِ من حيث الحقيقة مع أنه مخلوق. The Shaykh said, for example, we cannot, in essence, describe what would the bounty and the blessings and the beauty of Jannah will be like. The things that you will enjoy in Jannah, you cannot really describe them in their ultimate truth. مع أنه مخلوق. Even though Jannah is created. في الجنة فاكهة ونخل. In Jannah there are fruits and palm trees, وَرُمَّانٌ وَسُرُرٌ وَأَكْوَابٌ. There's pomegranates or pomegranates, and there are vessels, and there are thrones, and there are, you know, حور, the most anticipated for most men, the حور العين. May Allah Azza wa Jal bless us with as many حور العين as possible. وَنَحْنُ لَا نُدْرِكُ حَقِيقَةَ هَذِهِ الْأَشْيَاءِ. And we don't have, we cannot grasp the reality of these matters. You don't know. You don't know. You hear Ruman, you hear Nakhil, you think of the you know, pomegranate that you buy from the supermarket, or you think of the palm tree down the street. In reality, Jannah is nothing like that. وَنَحْنُ لَا نُدْرِكُ حَقِيقَةَ هَذِهِ الْأَشْيَاءِ وَلَوْ قِيلَ صِفْهَ لَنَا لَا نَصْلَعُ وَصِفَهَا. Someone said, describe those for me. You say, I cannot describe them. لِقَوْلِهِ تَعَالَى فَلَا تَعْلَمُ نَفْسٌ مَا أُخْفِيَ لَهُمْ مِنْ قُرَّةِ أَعْيُنٍ جَزَاءً بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ. Allah says in regards to that, and no person knows what is kept hidden for them of joy as a reward for what they used to do. ولقوله تعالى في الحديث القدسي أعددت لعبادي الصالحين ما لا عين رأت ولا أذن سمعت ولا خطر على قلب بشر. Allah says in the Hadith Qudsi, I have prepared for my righteous slaves what no eye has ever seen, what no ear has ever heard, and what has never come across a human's heart or mind. Therefore, even if you were to spend the rest of your life, and even if you were to live the life of Nuh and even longer, which is not going to happen, if you spent your entire life trying to imagine what Jannah will be like, you will fail. Because the Hadith said, what no eye has ever seen, what no ear has ever heard, and what has never come across a human's mind. Meaning whatever imagination Allah has allowed in this world, imagining the matters of Jannah are excluded from that. The Shaykh said, rahimahullah, فَإِذَا كَانَ هَذَا فِي الْمَخْلُوقِ الَّذِي وُصِفَ بِصِفَاتٍ مَعْلُومَةِ الْمَعْنَى وَلَا تُعْلَمْ حَقِيقَتُهَا فَكَيْفَ بِالْخَالِقِ. If this is the case in regards to the creation that has been described with things that the meaning of which we know, but the essence of which we don't know, then how about the Creator? So the Shaykh is saying, when we hear you know, palm trees or you know, fruits and rivers, you're familiar with those things. And even though you're familiar, you still don't know what it's going to be like in Jannah, even though those are things that are similar to the created and the creation. Then how would you then say about the Creator? That means you will never be able to grasp what those attributes are like, because it's from the matters of the unseen. مثال آخر, another example. الإنسان فيه روح. The human has a soul. لا يحيى إلا بها. He cannot be alive except through that soul. لولا أن الروح في بدنه ما حيى. Had the soul not been in his body, he wouldn't be alive. ولا يستطيع أن يصف الروح. And he's never able to describe the soul. لو قيل له ما هذه الروح التي بك. If someone said, can you describe the soul that is within you? ما هي التي لو نزعت منك صرت جثة وإذا بقيت فأنت إنسان تعقل وتفهم وتدرك. What is that thing in you that if it's removed from you, you become a corpse? And if it remains in you, you become a human, a functioning human who's able to understand and comprehend and grasp things. لَجَلَسَ يَنْظُرُ وَيُفَكِّرُ فَلَا يَسْتَطِيعُ أَنْ يَصِفَهَا أَبَدًا. He will stay for a long time reflecting and thinking. He will never be able to describe the soul. مَعَ أَنَّهَا قَرِيبَةً مِنْهُ. Even though it's very close to him. فِي نَفْسِهِ وَبَيْنَ جَنْبَيْهِ. It is within him and is between his two sides. وَيَعْجَزُ عَنْ إِدْرَاكِهَا. However, he is unable to truly encompass it in understanding. مع أنها حقيقة, even though it is real and it is true. يعني شيء يرى, meaning it's something that is visible. كما أخبر النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام بأن الروح إذا قبض أن الروح إذا قبض تبعه البصر. When the soul is taken, the eyesight follows it. فالإنسان يرى نفسه وهي مقبوضة. The person will see his soul when it has been captured by the angel of death. ولهذا تبقى العين مفتوحة عند الموت تشاهد روح. That's why the eye remains open at the time of death because it's observing the soul leaving. And you've seen this, if you've ever seen a video compilation of people passing away during a lecture, during a talk, or on the hospital bed, you see, for the most part, you will be able to see the person looking up, seeing their soul. Subhanallah al-Azim, what a moment. May Allah make it easy upon us leaving the body. فالإنسان يرى نفسه وهي مقبوضة ولهذا تبقى لنعم وتؤخذ هذه الروح وتجعل في كفن. Then that soul will be taken and will be placed into a shroud, which we've discussed before. ويصعد بها إلى الله. It will be ascended unto Allah عز وجل. ومع ذلك ما يستطيع أن يصفها. In spite of all that, he's unable to describe it. وهي بين جنبيه. And it is between his two sides. فكيف يحاول أن يصف الرب بأمر لم يصف به نفسه. Then how in the world will he be able to describe Allah with something that Allah did not describe himself with? If you can't describe your own soul because you haven't seen it and your soul is created, then how in the world would you be able to describe the Creator with something that he did not describe himself with, and you haven't seen him, and he is the creator of the created. You don't even have anything to use as qiyas. You have nothing to use as a resemblance or as an example. وَلَا بُدَّ إِذَنْ تَحَقُّكِ ثُبُوتِ الصِّفَاتِ لِلَّهِ. So then it is inevitable that we should affirm the qualities of Allah Azza wa Jal. The third discussion. The third subject. المبحث الثالث أننا لا نصف الله تعالى بما لم يصف به نفسه. We do not describe Allah with that which He did not describe Himself with. ودليل ذلك أيضا من السمع والعقل. And the evidence for that is also evidence based. When they say سمع أخوان أخوات, سمع which is hearing, it means as in revelation that you hear from the Quran or the Sunnah. ذكرنا من السمع آيتين. We've mentioned two ayat from the revelation. وأما من العقل فقلنا إن هذا أمر غيبي لا يمكن إدراكه بالعقل وضربنا لذلك مثلين. So this, the third subject is exactly like the second subject. Just like we gave evidence from the Quran that you shouldn't speak about Allah without knowledge. You shouldn't go chasing that and following that which you have no knowledge of. So you only describe Allah with what He described Himself with. Similarly, with the same ayat, you may not, that we do not describe Allah Azza wa Jal with that which He did not describe Himself with. So there's affirmation and then there is negation. And the same thing with intellect. It's from the matters of the unseen. So you cannot describe Allah with something that He did not describe Himself with. المبحث الرابع وجوب إجراء النصوص الواردة في الكتاب والسنة على ظاهرها لا نتعداها. Very, very, very important. The fourth subject is the obligation. Pay attention, يا أخوان and أخوات. The obligation of holding the textual proofs in the Quran and the Sunnah as per the apparent meaning, we never exceed that. We never go beyond that. The apparentness and the apparent meaning is the reliable source for us. مثال ذلك لما وصف الله نفسه بأن له عينا هل نقول المراد بالعين الرؤية لا حقيقة العين؟ لو قلنا ذلك ما وصفنا الله أو ما وصفنا الله بما وصف به نفسه. For example, if Allah Azza wa Jal described Himself as having an eye, do we say what is intended with the eye is only vision or the actual eye? If we were to say that what is intended is the only vision, then we have not described Allah with that which He described Himself with. Do you understand the subject matter? Because Allah confirmed that He has a ayn. So if you say, it's not ayn, it's only vision. On what basis are you denying what Allah described Himself with and giving it another meaning? وَلَمَّا وَصَفَ اللَّهُ نَفْسَهُ بِأَنَّ لَهُ يَدَيْنِ And Allah described Himself as having two hands. Allah says, بَلْ يَدَاهُ مَبْسُوطَتَانِ Nay, both of His hands are widely stretched out or widely outstretched. لو قلنا إن الله تعالى ليس له يد حقيقة بل المراد باليد ما يسبغه من النعم على عباده فهل وصفنا الله بما وصف به نفسه؟ لا. And if we were to say Allah عز وجل does not truly have a hand, rather, what is intended by the hand of Allah is that which Allah has bestowed upon His servants of His many bounties. Then would we be describing Allah with what He described Himself with? No. Because Allah could have used the word ni'am. He could have used the word barakat. He could have used the word rizq. Allah could have used the terms that they want to refer to. But Allah chose to use hands. So if Allah chose hands, who are you to come and tell Allah, no, I'm not going to affirm that for you, O Allah. I'm going to give it another meaning. Now, this other meaning that you're bringing about, that is not what the meaning, not what the apparent word means. Did the Prophet ﷺ guide you to that for you to say the Messenger of Allah said, nope. And we will challenge any mubtadi' to be able to bring forth such an evidence. Did the Sahaba think that like that? Did the Sahaba who did the tafsir of the Quran say, Ya Muslims, what is intended by hands of Allah is the bounty of Allah? Did they? No. How about the Imams, the four Imams? No. So when did this happen? This happened when Muslims started learning Greek philosophy and they gave their mind the precedence over the legislation and the revelation, and they said, Al-Hakam yu'aqqal awwalan. Al-Aql yu'hakkam awwalan. First, we will use our intellect as the reliable means, because Allah gave us the intellect and the mind to understand. Therefore, we will believe what should be believed as per the agreement of our intellect, and we will deny what should be denied, which our intellect does not accept. And little did they know that what they're doing is falling into a greater calamity than the one they're trying to avoid. Had they accepted what Allah described Himself with and kept their mouths closed, wallahi, it would have been over. And intellects vary. So if your intellect doesn't accept it, other people's intellect accepts it. And what do they quote usually to justify their deviance? لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ There's nothing like unto him. Whenever someone says, say, okay, finish the ayah. Tell him to finish the ayah. وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ and he is the all-hearing, all-seeing. Ya Sheikh, the one who told you there's nothing like unto him, told you he is all-seeing and all-hearing. They deny this. They deny that Allah hears. They deny that Allah sees, but they want to say there's nothing like Allah. So they basically pick from the Quran what is suitable for them and they accept it, and what their minds don't understand, they reject it. And they call themselves to be, submitters to Allah. Those are the Asha'ira for you, who today are being put on the same level as the people that follow the Aqeedah of Ahl-us-Sunnah wal-Jamaa'ah. No problem. Enough said. Al-Mabhath al-Khamis, the fifth subject. عموم كلام المؤلف يشمل كل ما وصف الله به نفسه من الصفات الذاتية المعنوية والخبرية والصفات الفعلية. This is very critical. Now, the general speech or words of the author is inclusive of everything that Allah described himself with of the sifatul dhatiyya, meaning the qualities or the attributes of his essence. Al-ma'nawiyya meaning those that are in meaning. So the attributes of his essence and meaning. Wal-khabariyya, which are derived from revealed information. Khabar is the news that you receive. Huh? The news. So those which are come from revelation. وَالصِّفَاتِ الْفِعْلِيَّةِ and the action, the attributes of action. Anything that Allah Azza wa Jal does falls under that. Now, I know those appear to be a little complicated, but don't panic because we're going to go in there very soon, inshallah. فَالصِّفَاتُ الذَّاتِيَّةِ هِيَ الَّتِي لَمْ يَزَلْ وَلَا يَزَالُ مُتَّصِفًا بِهَا وَهِيَ نَوْعَانَ مَعْنَوِيَّةٌ وَخَبَرِيَّةٌ. The attributes of his essence are those that Allah has never ceased, nor will he ever cease to be described with. He never ceased, nor will he ever cease to be described with. And those are of two types, ma'nawiyyatun wa khabariyya. As we explained earlier, ma'nawiyya meaning those of meaning, khabariyya those of information and revelation. Huh? Those are information, in revealed information. طيب. فالمعنوية مثل, the example of the معنوية such as الحياة, life, والعلم, knowledge, والقدرة, power or ability, والحكمة, wisdom, وما أشبه ذلك, وهذا على سبيل التمثيل للحصر. These are examples, and we're not saying that this is everything. والخبرية as an example of the صفات الخبرية. So the معنوية are those four as an example. Khabariyya, the ones that are based on revelation, مِثْلُ الْيَدَيْنِ, like the two hands, وَالْوَجْهِ, the face, وَالْعَيْنَيْنِ, the two eyes. وَمَا أَشْبَهَ ذَلِكَ مِمَّا سَمَّاهِ نَظِيرُهُ أَبْعَاضُ وَأَجْزَاءٌ لَنَا. Okay, such as the two hands, the face, and the two eyes, and the like from what he named, while something of that is used to describe us as well. Right? يعني this is similar to what we describe a human with, as in he has hands and face and eyes. Because Allah has hands and face and eyes, but of course we've already established and we will continue to establish that there's absolutely no resemblance between them. Because many, the term hands can be used for many things. And it doesn't have to be a human hand. An ant has a hand, an animal has a hand, humans have a hand, the door has a hand. And all of these are, the term hand is used across all of these, and there's absolutely no resemblance between these hands, even though the term used is the same. If this is the case between the various creations, then what about the difference between the creation and the creator? فَاللَّهُ تَعَالَى لَمْ يَزَلْ لَهُ يَدَانْ وَوَجْهٌ وَعَيْنَانْ. Allah Azza wa Jal never ceased to have hands, two hands, and a face and two eyes. لَمْ يَحْدُثْ لَهُ شَيْءٍ مِنْ ذَلِكَ بَعْدَ أَنْ لَمْ يَكُنْ. None of that happened or changed after that was the case. So these have always been around. وَلَمْ يَنْفَكَّ عَنْ شَيْءٍ مِنْهِ. And they never ceased to exist from him. كَمَا أَنَّ اللَّهَ لَمْ يَزَلْ حَيًّا وَلَا يَزَلُ حَيًّا. Allah Azza wa Jal has always been alive and will always be alive. لَمْ يَزَلْ عَالِمًا وَلَا يَزَلُ عَالِمًا. He's always been knowledgeable and he is still knowledgeable. وَلَمْ يَزَلْ قَادِرًا وَلَا يَزَلُ قَادِرًا. He's ever been capable and powerful, and he remains to be capable and powerful. وَهَكَذَا, and so on and so forth. يَعْنِي لَيْسَ حَيَاتُهُ تَتَجَدَّدْ. Meaning Allah's life is not renewable. ولا قدرته تتجدد. His power is not renewable. ولا سمعه يتجدد. His hearing is not renewable. بل هو موصوف بهذا أزلا وأبدا. However, rather he is described with this and never cease to be described in this manner forever and eternity. وتجدد المسموع لا يستلزم تجدد سمع. The fact that Allah hears things because new sounds are made doesn't mean that the quality of hearing is being renewed. فأنا مثلا عندما أسمع الأذان الآن فهذا ليس معناها أنه حدث لي سمع جديد. The Shaykh said, if I hear the Adhan now, it doesn't mean that I have a new quality of hearing عند سماع الأذان, because I'm hearing the Adhan. بل هو منذ خلقه الله فيه. Rather, since Allah created me, I've had the quality of hearing. لكن المسموع يتجدد. However, that which is being heard is what is being renewed. وهذا لا أثر له في الصفة. And that has no effect on the actual attribute of hearing. واصطلح العلماء رحمهم الله على أن يسموها الصفات الذاتية. قالوا لأنها ملازمة للذات لا تنفك عنها. So the scholars, may Allah have mercy on them, they termed them as the attributes of essence, because they are inseparable from the that, from Allah's self. And Allah Azza wa Jal is not separate from them at any point in time. والصفات الفعلية هي الصفات المتعلقة بمشيئته. As for the action, qualities are those that are associated with his will. وهي نوعان, and they are of two types. صفات لها سبب معلوم, attributes which have a reason, they have a cause that we are aware of. مثل الرضا, such as Allah being pleased, the pleasure. فالله عز وجل إذا وجد سبب الرضا رضي. Allah عز وجل, if there's a reason for him to become pleased, then Allah becomes pleased. كما قال تعالى إن تكفروا فإن الله غني عنكم. If you disbelieve, then Allah عز وجل is no need of you. Allah is in no need of you. ولا يرضى لعباده الكفر. And he likes not disbelief for his slaves. He actually is unpleased and displeased with kufr for his slaves. وَإِن تَشْكُرُوا يَرْضَهُ لَكُمْ. This is the key. And if you are grateful by being believers, then he is pleased therewith for you. So that's an example of a reason behind it. وَصِفَاتٌ that we know. وَصِفَاتٌ لَيْسَ لَهَا سَبَبٌ مَعْلُومٌ. And there are other examples and other attributes which have unknown causes. مثل النزول إلى سماء الدنيا حين يبقى ثلث الليل آخر, such as Allah عز وجل descending to the lowest heaven during the last third of the night. Allah عز وجل descends in a manner which befits His Majesty in the last third of the night, every single night. And we don't know the reason. There's an unknown cause. Allah عز وجل willed it and Allah عز وجل does it. ومن الصفات ما هو صفة ذاتية وفعلية باعتبارين. And there are other types of attributes that can be both an attribute of essence and an attribute of action or doing at the same time. فالكلام صفة فعلية باعتبار أحده. For example, speaking is an attribute of doing on its own. لكن باعتبار أصله صفة ذاتية. But when we go back to its origin, it's actually one of the that, one of the attributes of Allah's essence. Allah's self subhanahu wa ta'ala. لأن الله لم يزل ولا يزال متكلما. Allah never ceases to stop and continues to be one who speaks. لكنه يتكلم بما شاء متى شاء. However, he speaks whatever he wills, whenever he wills. كما سيأتي في بحث الكلام إن شاء الله تعالى. As we will discuss later in the discussion on the speech بإذن الله, on Allah's quality of speaking. اصطلح العلماء رحمهم الله أن يسموا هذه الصفات الصفات الفعلية لأنها من فعله سبحانه وتعالى. So the scholars, may Allah have mercy on them, they termed this as the attributes of actions or the attributes of Allah's doings because they are from Allah's actions and Allah's doings. ولهذا أدلة كثيرة من القرآن. And that has ample evidences from the Quran. مثل وجاء ربك والملك صفا صفا. And your Lord and the angels will come in rows upon rows. هل ينظرون إلا أن تأتيهم الملائكة أو يأتي ربك. Allah further says, do they then wait for anything other than the angels should come to them or that your Lord should come? Radiallahu anhum wa radu an. Allah is pleased with them and they are pleased with him. Walakin kariha Allahum bi'athahum fathabbatahum. But Allah was averse to their being sent forth, so he made them lag behind. And سَخِطَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ وَفِي الْعَذَابِ هُمْ خَالِدُونَ. For that reason, Allah's wrath fell upon them, and in torment they will abide. وَلَيْسَ فِي إِثْبَاتِهَا لِلَّهِ تَعَالَى نَقْصٌ بِوَجْهٍ مِنَ الْوُجُوهِ. And affirming those to Allah does not suggest any deficiency or imperfection in any way, shape or form. In any way, shape or form. بَلْ هَذَا مِنْ كَمَالِهِ أَنْ يَكُونَ فَاعِلًا لِمَا يُرِيدُ. Rather, this is from the perfection of Allah Azza wa Jal that He does whatever He wills. وَأُولَٰئِكَ الْقَوْمُ الْمُحَرِّفُونَ يَقُولُونَ. However, there's a group of people, those who distort the meanings of Allah's attributes. They say, إِثْبَاتُهَا مِنَ النَّقْصِ. They say, affirming these attributes indicates deficiency and imperfection. وَلِهَذَا يُنْكِرُونَ جَمِيعَ الصِّفَاتِ الْفِعْلِيَّةِ. That's why they deny all of the actions of Allah, all of the attributes of action. يَقُولُونَ لَا يَجِي وَلَا يَرْضَى وَلَا يَسْقَطْ وَلَا يَكْرَهْ وَلَا يُحِبْ. They say he does not come, and he is not pleased, and he does not become angry, and he does not hate, and he does not love. They deny all of these. يُنْكِرُونَ كُلَّ هَذِهِ بِدَعْوَ أَنَّ هَذِي حَادِثَ. They deny all of them, claiming that these are newly occurring events. وَالْحَادِثُ لَا يَقُومُ إِلَّا بِحَادِثٍ. And they say that a new event is not established except by another new event. The Shaykh said, وَهَذَا بَاطِلْ. This is false. لِأَنَّهُ مِنْ مُقَابَلَةِ النَّصِ. Because you are using this to oppose the text. وَهُوَ بَاطِلٌ بِنَفْسِي. And it's also false on of its, in and of its own, even if we don't use the text. فَإِنَّهُ لَا يَلْزَمُ مِنْ حُدُوثِ الْفِعْلِ حُدُوثِ الْفَاعِلِ. Because it is not necessary if there's an action that there's a cause behind the action. It does not necessitate a new doer for the action that takes place. So a newly occurring action does not necessitate a new doer, as the accurate translation shows. المبحث السادس أن العقل لا مدخل له في باب الأسماء والصفات. The sixth subject is that intellect has no room, has no interference, cannot even enter onto the subject of the names and attributes. The intellect should be placed on hold, on vacation, and is off the subject matter. لأن مدار إثبات الأسماء والصفات أن أو نفيها على السمع. Really? Because the subject matter of affirming the names and attributes or denying it is based on textual evidence. فَعُقُولُنَا لَا تُحَكَّمْ عَلَى اللَّهِ أَبَدًا. Never, ever can we use our intellect to make a judgment about Allah. فَالْمَدَارُ إِذَنْ عَلَى السَّمْعِ. So the whole subject matter revolves around textual evidence, what you hear from the Qur'an and the Sunnah. خِلَافًا لِلْأَشْعَرِيَّةِ وَالْمُعْتَزِلَةِ وَالْجَهْمِيَّةِ وَغَيْرِهِمْ مِنْ أَهْلِ التَّعْطِيلِ. Unlike and opposing the Ash'ara and the Mu'tazila and the Jahmites, the Ash'arites and the Mu'tazilites and the Jahmites and others from among those who deny and distort the names and attributes of Allah. الَّذِينَ جَعَلُوا الْمَدَارَ فِي إِثْبَاطِ الصِّفَاتِ أَوْ نَفِيَ عَلَى الْعَقْلِ. They made the subject matter or the reference in terms of affirming or negating the qualities of Allah their minds, their feeble minds or their non-existent minds. فَقَالُوا مَقْتَدَ الْعَقْلُ إِثْبَاتَهُ أَثْبَتْنَاهُ. They said, whatever the intellect suggests to affirm, we will affirm. سَوَاءٌ أَثْبَتَهُ اللَّهُ لِنَفْسِي أَمْ لَا. Whether Allah affirmed it to himself or not, it doesn't matter. If the mind allows it, we will allow it. وَمَا اقْتَدَى نَفْيُهُ نَفَيْنَاهُ. And whatever the intellect necessitates that we deny it, we will negate it and deny it. وَإِنْ أَثْبَتَهُ اللَّهُ. Even if Allah affirmed it. وَقَالَ إِنَّ دَلَالَةَ الْعَقْلِ إِيجَابِيَّةٌ. And they say that the intellect is something positive. فَإِنْ أَوْجَبَ الصِّفَةَ أَثْبَتْنَاهَا وَإِنْ لَمْ يُجِبْهَا نَفَيْنَاهَا. So if the mind in a positive way affirms a quality, we will affirm it, and if the mind or the intellect denies it, we will deny it. لكن لا ينكرها لأن العقل لا ينفيها لأن العقل لا يثبتها. Because the mind does not affirm it, but he doesn't deny it. لأن العقل لا ينفيها, because the mind doesn't deny it. ويقول نتوقف. They say, okay, this one we will stop. لأن دلالة العقل عند هذه سلبية. Because the mind, the intellect regarding this is negative. إذا لم يجب يتوقف ولم ينفي. So he doesn't affirm, he stops and he doesn't negate. يعني قسما بالله, it's just like a perpetual state of confusion. Like these people are just confused.
فصار هؤلاء يحكمون العقل بما يوجب بما يجب أو يمتنع على الله عز وجل.
So those people then, they dictate what their intellects necessitate or negate about Allah عز وجل.
فيتفرع على هذه ما اقتضى العقل وصف الله به وصف الله به.
So they say, as a byproduct, so they say, whatever the intellect judges as suitable to Allah to describe him with, وصف الله به, then Allah shall be described accordingly.
وَإِنْ لَمْ يَكُنْ فِي الْكِتَابِ وَالسُّنَّةِ. يَا شَيْخ, يَا شَيْخ.
Even if it is not in the book and the sunnah, even if it's not in the Quran and the sunnah, if the mind says Allah should be described in this manner, then we shall describe him in this manner.
وَمَا اقْتَدَى الْعَقْلُ نَفْيَهُ عَنِ اللَّهِ.
And whatever the mind or the intellect judges that we should negate for Allah, نَفَوْهُ, they will negate it.
وَإِنْ كَانَ فِي الْكِتَابِ وَالسُّنَّةِ.
Even if it is in the Quran and the sunnah.
عجيب, عجيب, يعني the craziness is unprecedented.
وَلِهَذَا يَقُولُونَ. That's why, therefore they will say,
لَيْسَ لِلَّهِ عَيْنٌ ولا وجه ولا له يد ولا استوى على العرش ولا ينزل إلى السماء الدنيا.
So they say Allah does not have an eye, and Allah does not have a face, and Allah does not have a hand, and Allah did not rise over His throne, Allah did not ascend over His throne, and Allah does not descend to the lowest heaven.
لكنهم يحرفون. Rather they will distort the meaning. ويسمون تحريفهم تأويلا.
And they will call their distortion a form of interpretation.
They're not going to tell you we're going to distort the meaning. That's too much in your face. That's too blatant.
They will say, no, 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 no. We're just giving another interpretation.
ولو أنكروا إنكار جحد لكفروا.
Because if they were just to deny, like outright deny, and distorted, like without giving another interpretation, they would have disbelieved.
لأنهم كذبوا, because they would have lied.
لكنهم ينكرون إنكار ما يسمونه تأويلا وهو عندنا تحريف.
So they deny it with the type of denial that they call interpretation. However, we call it distortion.
Hey.
والحاصل أن العقل لا مجال له في باب أسماء الله وصفاته.
The bottom line, my brothers and sisters, please understand. The conclusion is, the intellect has no room. The intellect is unwelcomed in the subject matter of the names and attributes of Allah.
You use your intellect to understand the revelation of Allah. Because we're not saying that we want you to shut down your brain. Don't be silly.
We're not saying, oh no, we don't want you to think. No, 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 no. You have to think. You must think. Allah says, أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ أَفَلَا يَتَفَكَّرُونَ. They do not reflect. Do they not think? Think. Think about understanding the revelation. Don't think so that you can neglect and negate and deny and disbelieve in the revelation. Do you understand the difference? We're talking about not using our mind to go against the revelation of the Quran and the Sunnah. We're not saying don't use your mind to understand the revelation of the Quran and the Sunnah. I know you are smart enough to understand what I'm referring to here.
Hey. فَإِنْ قُلْتَ قَوْلُكَ هَذَا يُنَاقِضُ الْقُرْآنِ. if you were to say this statement of yours contradicts the Quran. لِأَنَّ اللَّهَ يَقُولُ وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ مِنَ اللَّهِ حُكْمًا.
Because Allah says, and who is better in judgment than Allah? Huh? For a people who have firm faith.
وَالتَّفْضِيلُ بَيْنَ شَيْءٍ وَآخَرَ مَرْجِعُهُ إِلَى الْعَقْلِ.
And how do you differentiate and compare between two things? How do you prefer between one thing and another except by using the intellect?
وَقَالَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ وَلِلَّهِ الْمَثَلُ الْأَعْلَى.
And for Allah is the highest description.
وَقَالَ أَفَمَن يَخْلُقُ كَمَن لَّا يَخْلُقُ أَفَلَا تَذَكَّرُونَ.
And Allah says, is then he who creates as one who creates not? Will you not then remember?
وَأَشْبَهَ ذَلِكَ مِمَّا يُحِيلُ اللَّهُ بِهِ عَلَى الْعَقْلِ فِيمَا يُثْبِتُ لِنَفْسِهِ وَمَا يَنْفِيهِ عَنِ الْآلِهَةِ الْمُدَّعَاتِ.
And other examples of the sort where Allah Azza wa Jal will make the person use their intellect to affirm something Allah affirmed for himself or deny something that Allah Azza wa Jal had described for the false deities. One of the descriptions or what has been attributed to the false deities.
فَالْجَوَابُ أَن نَقُولُ إِنَّ الْعَقْلَ يُدْرِكُ مَا يَجِبُ لِلَّهِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى وَيَمْتَنِي عَلَيْهِ عَلَى سَبِيلِ الْإِجْمَالِ لَا عَلَى سَبِيلِ التَّفْصِيلِ.
We would reply by saying, the intellect can grasp what is required to describe Allah with the glorious and exalted is He, and what He should not be described with, generally speaking, but not specifically speaking.
فَمَثَلًا الْعَقْلُ يُدْرِكُ بِأَنَّ الرَّبَّ لَابُدَّ أَن يَكُونَ كَامِلَ الصِّفَاتِ.
The intellect understands and grasps that the Lord must have perfect attributes.
لكن يثبت أو ينفي على سبيل العموم أن الرب لا بد أن يكون كامل الصفات سالما من النقص.
However, he will affirm or negate, generally speaking, that the Lord must have the perfect attributes and also they should be free of any deficiency and imperfections.
فمثلا يدرك بأن له لا بد أن يكون الرب سميعا بصيرا.
The mind, the intellect understands that it is inevitable that the Lord must be all hearing, all seeing.
قَالَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ لِأَبِيهِ يَا أَبَتِ لِمَ تَعْبُدُ مَا لَا يَسْمَعُ وَلَا يُبْصِرُ.
Oh my father, why do you worship that which does not hear and does not see?
وَلَا بُدَّ أَن يَكُونَ خَالِقًا.
And Allah Azza wa Jal must be the creator.
لأن الله قال أفمن يخلق كمن لا يخلق.
Because Allah says, is he then who creates like he who creates not?
يدرك هذا. Your mind can grasp that.
ويدرك بأن الله سبحانه وتعالى يمتنع أن يكون حادثا بعد العدم.
And also your mind can understand that Allah cannot be described as existent after nothingness.
ولأنه نقص. Because that would be a form of deficiency.
ولقوله تعالى محتجا على هؤلاء الذين يعبدون الأصنام والذين يدعون من دون الله لا يخلقون شيئا وهم يخلقون.
Allah says regarding those who they worship besides Allah, those whom they invoke besides Allah have not created anything, but are themselves created.
إذا يمتنع أن يكون الخالق حادثا بالعقل.
So it is intellectually impossible that Allah Azza wa Jalla, the Creator, could ever be newly existent. Meaning, it couldn't be that there was no creator, then suddenly there was a creator. The creator is eternal. He's always been there. That's something that your intellect can grasp.
العقل أيضا يدرك بأن كل صفة نقص فهي ممتنعة لله.
The mind also can grasp and understand that any quality of imperfection is impossible for Allah.
لأن الرب لابد أن يكون كاملا.
Because the creator, the Lord must be perfect.
فيدرك بأن الله عز وجل مسلوب عنه العجز.
For example, we know that Allah عز وجل cannot be described with inability.
لأنه صفة نقص.
Because it's a quality of deficiency and imperfection.
إذا كان الرب عاجزا وعصيا وأراد أن يعاقب الذي عصاه وهو عاجز فلا يمكن.
If the Lord is incapable and he is disobeyed and he wanted to punish the one who disobeyed him, yet he is incapable, That is impossible.
إذن العقل يدرك بأن العجز لا يمكن أن يوصف الله به.
So the mind understands that incapability is something that it can never be attributed to Allah.
والعمى كذلك.
And also blindness. والصمم كذلك. And also deafness.
والجهل كذلك, and also ignorance. وهكذا على سبيل العموم ندرك ذلك. So generally speaking, we're able to grasp all that. لكن على سبيل التفصيل, but when we get into the specifics, the intricate ones, لا يمكن أن ندركه فنتوقف فيه على السمع. And that which our mind cannot grasp, this is where we then submit to the text. We submit to the revelation which we hear with our ears. The Shaykh said, سؤال, a question. هل هو هل كل ما هو كمال فينا يكون كمالا في حق الله؟ Is everything that is considered perfection for us in our case is also perfection in the case of Allah? وهل كل ما هو نقص فينا يكون نقصا في حق الله؟ And is everything that is imperfect in our case is also imperfect in the case of Allah? الجواب لا. The answer is no. لأن المقياس في الكمال والنقص ليس باعتبار ما يضاف الإنسان. Because the measurement or the assessment of perfection and imperfection is not as per what is attributed to the humans. لظهور الفرق بين الخالق والمخلوق, because of the vast difference between the creator and the creation. لكن باعتبار الصفة من حيث هي صفة فكل صفة كمال فهي ثابتة لله سبحانه وتعالى. As for the quality or the attribute, independently, every attribute of perfection that it is affirmed to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. فالأكل والشرب بالنسبة للخالق نقص. Eating and drinking, if we were to, in reference to the creator, is a deficiency and an imperfection. لأن سببهما الحاجة, because it is a byproduct of need. It's a byproduct of need. والله تعالى غني عما سواه. Allah عز وجل is sufficient and self-sufficient and is in no need of anyone else. لكنهما بالنسبة للمخلوق كمال. But as for the creation, then they are qualities of perfection. ولهذا إذا كان الإنسان لا يأكل, that's why if a person does not eat, فلا بد أن يكون عليلا بمرض. It is inevitable that he has some sort of illness أو نحوه or something of the sort. هذا نقص. This is imperfection. والنوم بالنسبة للخالق نقص. Similarly, sleeping in reference or in the case of the creator is a deficiency and an imperfection. وللمخلوق كمال. And as for the creation, it is a quality of perfection. Because if you don't sleep, you will start tripping. And you will just, you know, you're malfunction. You can't understand anymore. You will knock out. You might even die. Might get in a car accident and fall asleep in the middle of it. So not sleeping is perfection for humans because you need it to remain well. For Allah, if Allah were to sleep, subhanahu wa ta'ala, then who will manage the world? So for Allah, it's a quality of imperfection. For the creation, it's a quality of perfection. I'm sure you understand the difference. التكبر, very important. التكبر كمال للخالق ونقص للمخلوق. Pride is a form of perfection for the creator, and it is an imperfection for the created and the creation. لأنه لا يتم الجلال والعظمة إلا بالتكبر. You cannot attain the majesty and the greatness except by being prideful. حتى تكون السيطرة كاملة, so that the control will be and the authority will be in the ultimate sense. ولا أحد ينازعه, and no one can compete against him. ولهذا توعد الله تعالى من ينازعه الكبرياء والعظمة, قال من نازعني واحد منهما عذبته. That's what Allah Azza wa Jal promised to anyone who will show pride and greatness for himself. Allah says in the hadith, whosoever will compete with me in one of them, I shall punish him. I will punish him. And this is based on the hadith that was narrated by Imam Muslim. So be careful, my brothers and sisters, of being prideful. An example of being prideful is that when you are upon falsehood and someone advises you and tries to knock some sense into you, you say, everybody is underqualified. No one is at my level. I am this, I am that, I am this,
I am that, and you constantly speak about your qualifications and your credentials and your achievements and your uniqueness and how wonderful you are and how special you are and how knowledgeable you are and how the rest of the world are nothing but sophomores, neophytes, neo-madkhalis, pseudo-madkhalis, names and names and names are given to belittle other people because you're the only sheikh in the dunya. But the cutest thing about this is, with all this pride, it is so cute to say, I say with all humbleness. I say with nothing in my heart, but Ya Allah, forgive them. Those, you know, people that speak, يعني, شيخ, استغفر الله العظيم وتوب إليه. All this fakeness, يا أخي, فكنا يا شيخ. والله عيب, عيب. Pride belongs to Allah Azza wa Jal. We are nothing, we are nothing. You mention your qualification if there's a context for doing it. And even when you do it, يعني, a person is hurt that he has to mention that I am this and I am that. If you do it more than once, and if you do it regularly, wallahi, there's something wrong. Wallahi, it is pride. And a hadith is warning any one of us who believes he has... Look at the other mashayikh with all that they have achieved. They don't even let someone call him a student of knowledge, ya sheikh. غفر الله لنا وله للمسلمين وهدانا لما يحبهم ويرضاه من القول طيب نعم so هذه ستة مباحث تحت قولي these are six different subject matters under the title ما وصف به نفسه what Allah has described himself with وكلها مباحث هم all of them are important subject matters وقدمناها بين يدي العقيدة we have put this forth in the introduction of this Aqeedah لأنه سينبني عليها ما يأتي إن شاء الله تعالى because everything that will come afterwards will be built upon this foundation. So with this إن شاء الله we will conclude in our next session بإذن الله عز وجل we will be discussing the subject matter of what the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم described Allah سبحانه وتعالى with in the Sunnah. May Allah عز وجل make that easy for us and facilitate our affair. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك أتوب إليك السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
Thanks for watching this video. Subscribe and click on the notification bell. Like, comment, and share with friends and family.